Baker's yeast taught to make psilocybin. 1317 April 18, 2020. Danish scientists have introduced enzyme genes to Baker's yeast that provide psilocybin synthesis, according to metabolic engineering. The genes turned out to be functional in the new organism and helped to produce the desired alkaloid. At the same time, the modified yeast did not need to add intermediate products of its synthesis to the nutrient medium, such as 4-hydroxyendol. Psilocybin, an alkaloid of the fungus genus psilocybin and some others. Because it has a hallucinogenic effect, it is banned in many countries. However, in recent years, psilocybin has been found to have potent antidepressant properties. It also reduced anxiety in cancer patients and did not cause serious side effects. A series of clinical trials are currently evaluating its ability to reduce alcohol cravings. If the substance proves to be effective and safe, its status may be reviewed and used to treat the described conditions. Then you need to get it in large enough quantities. It is very expensive to extract psilocybin from psilocybe. Its weight is 0.2-1% of the total dry weight of the mushroom. Therefore, it makes sense to teach other organisms to produce this substance in large quantities. Better to choose those that are already used in biotechnology. To do this, model organisms need to be able to synthesize enzymes that ensure the synthesis of psilocybin from precursors. This is a multi-step process. Each reaction requires its own enzyme, and here its gene may not work outside the cells of the fungi. This problem arose when psilocybin taught to do E. coli. Then it turned out that the mushroom catalyst for one of the most important reactions in the chain, the addition of a hydroxyl group to the fourth carbon atom of the indel ring, does not function. Therefore, the bacteria had to add ready-made 4-hydroxyindol to the nutrient medium. Employees of the Danish Technical University, led by Irina Borodina, introduced the genes of the enzymes necessary for the synthesis of psilocybin from glucose into a closer psilocybe organism, Baker's yeast. This is also a mushroom. All genes required, with one exception, were derived from psilocybe cubensis. Among them was the gene for an enzyme that catalyzes the hydroxylation of the indel ring. The yeast was able to synthesize all the necessary enzymes, and therefore psilocybin. Unlike E. coli, yeast did not need to add unusual substances to the nutrient medium. Glucose served as the raw material for the production of the alkaloid. The maximum yield of psilocybin was 627 milligrams per liter of yeast culture. The mushrooms also produced the breakdown product of psilocybin, psilocene, at a concentration of up to 580 milligrams per liter in addition. It turned out that the modified yeast also produces other tryptamines, in particular, biocystin, norbiocystin and aeruginosin. At the same time, which is quite important, ethanol did not accumulate in the yeast culture. This is not the first time psilocybin is synthesized by other fungi that are normally unable to do so. Earlier, researchers from the University of Jena achieved the expression of genes that provide the formation of the corresponding alkaloid in Aspergillus nigrans. Although this fungus is widespread, yeast cultivation techniques are better developed, so it should be more profitable to obtain this alkaloid from S. cerevisia. The work is also interesting in that it is an example of the operation of an enzyme constructor in synthetic biology. If you choose the right combination of biological catalysts and introduce them into the cells of some model organism, you can theoretically obtain not only already known substances, but also those that do not occur in nature. Considering how many indole derivatives exist and how diverse their functions are, the assembly of systems for their synthesis will be useful not only in psychopharmacology, but also for the production of drugs of a different profile, as well as for agronomy, perfumery and many other industries. Baker's yeast is a classic object of biotechnology. The number of substances that have learned to synthesize with their help is enormous. Among them are morphine, various cannabinoids, noscapan, geraniol and linalool. Svetlana Yastrebova,